am Megan Boudreau from Spokane, Washington. I own and operate Lux Salon and Spa. I've been in the industry about 15 years, and I've been using Goldwell for currently 10 years. I think it's been the foundation of my business, and it's helped me grow my clientele. Here is Vicky, our model. We're going to be doing a graduated bob haircut. We just got done with her Goldwell color. I used a 9 ash on her roots, lifted it up, and then added some balayage highlights around her face to add lightness to attract to her beautiful eyes and lips. So we're gonna get started. Looking for her natural fall line. Vicky wears her hair in the middle, so we're gonna go that. Starting at the nape. In my opinion, the graduated bob is the most sought after haircut. It's one of the hardest haircuts to master. And my clips. I'm gonna do diagonal forward partings. Zero elevation. We're just taking a little bit off of Vicky's hair because she's been wearing her hair like this for a little bit and it looks really good with her face shape. Vicky has a natural oval face shape, so this cut really complements her features. Thank you. just taking quarter inch sections. Still doing graduated cord. Then I'll let my rest of the hair fall. There's not going to be any really hair because we kind of did some hidden layers last time. So I'm going to bring out this front section. Vicky's fringe is still kind of growing in a little bit from our last time we went short with her. So there's not going to be much to cut on this side. Obviously, we want this to grow. I'm going to comb this back, connect it with back hair just to see where my guide's at to keep that line nice and straight. Angled forward, it's a little longer around the face. Let the rest of his hair fall. Overdirect it back. Connect my back guide and just take off that little corner. I'm gonna have Vicky turn and tilt your head. I'm just gonna see if you. Make sure there's no hair behind the ear that can get caught. Zero elevation.
over, directing it back. Connecting with your back guy. Top section full. Section fall out and tilt her head. Just check the front. Okay, we're gonna add some choppy layers in there. So I'm just gonna do a little freeform cutting, starting at the crown. I'm gonna do a pivoting section. I'm gonna slow forward. Starting at her crown, I'm going to take half-inch sections. Over-directing the hair from shorter at the crown to longer towards the face. I'm going to be point cutting. From that last section, half inch section. Repeating the process. I'm almost making like pie-shaped partings and using her crown as the center of the pie. Still over-directing it forward. out of the way so I know what I've done already. I'm gonna pin this out of the way as I complete the session. This is going to allow Vicky a little bit more height than her crown where she needs the volume. Thank you. I'm just going to go back in and just add a little bit of texture in and around the crown to give Vicky some nice movement. That way she curls it, she'll have some layers. And this is also a good way to cross check your work. So I take bigger sections, probably like 1.5 inches, 2 inches. Vicky's hair around her face down here is a little shorter, so we're gonna kind of just let that fall out. Now the guide will be shorter to longer, so we don't want to change the actual length of the hair. We're just going to cut into the hair, just add a little bit more movement. And it's just a good way to just to cross check and make sure all your lines match up. And if they don't, then you can snip a corner, make it perfect. Okay, and we can just cross check it on each side by pulling it out, seeing where it falls. Okay, we're ready to style. the top lip. It's great heat protection. Amazing volume. So I'm going to do a little flash drying just to get some of the water out, and then I'm going to be using a paddle brush just to make it, instead of a round brush, I don't want her ends to be too curly. Directing forward towards the face and over direct it on her part just to get that added lift. How you cut it. Before I paddle brush. now that we have it dry, I'm just going to go back in and take a look and do any finishing work that might need to happen. Want there to be a little bit more movement right in this side right here. Do a little freeform cutting. And a little bit more texture and movement. Kind of use your mirror and see a little bit more height and width. This crown. Okay, so Vicky has the option of wearing her hair either straight, a little flat iron, or she can put in some curls and add some beach waves. So I think today we're just gonna kind of straighten the ends a little bit and throw in some Malibu and give a little texture. Again. little bit of metal glue. Just a little tiny bit because her hair is fine. This will have a little bit of separation to the hair. So I just want to say thank you again for the opportunity, and I look forward to hearing from you.